Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Okay, so as on the screen, a graph is being represented, and by following that we could determine or we could study what is depression in freezing point. So let us study in very deep. Consider the curve AB, which is for a pure solvent, which has a vapor pressure, a fixed vapor pressure. I will write it as P naught. The reason P naught, because it is for a pure solvent. So my main aim is to decrease the temperature. Why? Because I am converting a liquid into a solid. So in the previous lecture where we have to increase the temperature for a liquid so as to convert into gas, now we are decreasing the temperature so as the liquid can be converted into a solid. So what is the benchmark or what is the point that we should reach to convert a liquid into a solid? And that criteria or that benchmark is nothing but this solid solvent curve. We have to make the curve A to reach at point B so that the pure solvent will now be converted into a solid. So in this case, the temperature is now being decreased until point B. Until point B, the temperature that we get is T naught, which is for pure solvent. And since we are calculating it for, and since we are calculating for freezing point, so this T naught will be the freezing point for pure solvent. Now let us talk about a solution. So as we know earlier also that the solution will have a vapor pressure less than that of a pure solvent. So therefore this point C represents the vapor pressure at the same temperature itself for the solution. And the thing that we have to do is now we have to decrease the temperature so that this curve or this point should reach the point D where it will get freezed or where it will get converted into solid. So as the temperature decreases, the vapor pressure also decreases and it will decrease at point D. And the point which represents D has a corresponding temperature of T, which means the freezing point for the solution. So by this, as you can see, if the concentration increases, the vapor pressure decreases, and according to that, there will be change in TF, or there will be change in the difference between the freezing point of pure solvent and freezing point of solution. And this difference is nothing but depression in freezing point. It's so simple. And the difference, that is delta TF, will be nothing but T, and the difference will be nothing but TF minus T naught F minus TF. Contribution. And the difference will be nothing but delta TF is equals to T naught F minus TF, which means T naught F has a higher value compared to T naught F. So we have decreased the freezing point, or we have depressed, we have suppressed the freezing point of the solution by adding solute in it. The more the amount of solute, then the there will be more depression in freezing point. So by this we could control or we could analyze the amount of solute required to decrease the freezing point of a solution. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood what is depression in freezing point. So please don't forget to share this video with your friends and do subscribe to ekeeda.com. Thank you so much.